Facebook's mantra since it was founded has been move fast and break things. And now the social media giant has its sights set on a new target, how we buy and sell things. This week, Facebook announced plans to launch Libra, a global digital currency. With backing from such companies as PayPal, Uber, Visa, and MasterCard, Libra would allow users without bank accounts or credit cards to shop online. But the plan comes as Facebook finds itself under intense scrutiny for its privacy practices. Here to talk about it is CNET Senior Managing Editor Dan Ackerman. Dan, good morning.
Hey, guys.
Well, Chris, oh, how about that? Chris.
Reunion.
There you go. Yeah.
There you go.
Go ahead.
Chris Hughes, the co-founder of Facebook, called this plan just off the bat frightening. And I think part of it is the mystery surrounding it all. How does this work?
There is a lot of mystery surrounding it, and the idea of Facebook getting into cryptocurrency sets off red alerts with a lot of people. The way it would initially work is through something like WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger, which they really, really, really want everybody to use all the time. You'd be able to send this Libra currency. It's not quite the same as Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies because it's controlled by a central governing authority. That's Facebook and like these 28 other companies. So even though we're talking about it like Facebook money and people are calling them Zuckbucks, they claim they're just going to be one partner out of many.
Why do they want to do this? Why are they getting into this?
You know, the reason they give is actually a good and useful and important one. There are a lot of people out there that do not have credit cards, do not have access to regular bank accounts or checking accounts, and frankly, they're excluded from a lot of modern life. You go into, you know, half the coffee shops here in New York, and they don't take cash anymore. And if you don't have a credit card or a debit card, what are you going to do?
Yeah.
The ability to use your phone, let's say, to pay for something, and not even in the U.S., in other countries around the world, that's a legitimate purpose.
It's huge.
When people hear about digital currency, they still think of Bitcoin first, right? So how is Bitcoin doing right now, and how does the field look in general when it comes to the competition for digital currency?
It certainly sounds like, you know, Facebook's version of Bitcoin, and even though they're both cryptocurrencies, they're different. People have these giant server farms set up in icy locations to mine Bitcoin, and that's gotten progressively harder over the years. It's not really centrally controlled. This is much, much more traditional, almost like being on the gold standard, backed up by actual real-world assets and tied to certain currencies and the value of those assets. So it should be much more stable than Bitcoin, which can, or other cryptocurrencies, which can fluctuate up and down greatly, which means they're not really that useful in the real world.
Facebook has been criticized as already being somewhat of a monopoly in the tech world. What are the ramifications of them having this kind of control? And have they really looked at the ripple effects here?
You know, if you look up unintended consequences in the dictionary, you're going to find a big picture of Facebook and maybe Twitter and a few other of these guys. Obviously, the idea of, like, Facebook controlling money, you know, seems very frightening. They say that they're going to, you know, this data will be kept entirely separate from your social media data, but the company does not have the greatest track record in that sort of thing, which I think is one of the reasons why they're emphasizing this is not Facebook, it's Libra, which is a separate organization controlled by all these other separate companies, but many of them are like, you know, Visa, MasterCard, and Uber, companies that may also have data privacy issues.
Yeah, Facebook really trying to earn everybody's trust back
trying,
right now.
Trying.
That's
a tough one.
Yeah, trying.
The engine that could.
Dan, thank you very much.
Thanks.